temptation right here. This is demonic. You're demonic. See, this is hatred. This is not self-control. This is not self-control. This is not true love. This is not true love. No, God's way is love. God is light. And not darkness. This is darkness. You're fellowshipping with darkness. Oh, the Bible says, or do you despise the riches of his goodness, forbearance, and long-suffering, not knowing that the goodness of God leads you to repentance? Don't you know that it's the goodness of God that leads you to repentance? Where's the repentance? Where's the change of mind? Where's the change of heart? Where's the changing from darkness to light? Where's the change? I don't see the change. It's all going down the same path as the world. The rest of the world and its dispensation of unrighteousness, you're all going down the same path. You're all going down the same way. Or do you despise the riches of God's goodness, forbearance, and long-suffering? We are being long-suffering with you. God's forbearance with you. We're trying to give you what the Word of God says that would open the blinded eyes. You're perishing. You don't see it. You're deceived. You're just not understanding what we're trying to do. It's love, I'm telling you. It's true love. Man, we would embrace you here to pray for you. We would embrace you to show you that you're confused. You're not walking according to the way that God made you. God made you upright. You've changed the way that he's made you. You've turned it away from the way that he's made you. You've defiled yourself. Or do you despise the riches of his goodness, forbearance, and long-suffering, not knowing that the goodness of God leads you to repentance, but in accordance with your hardness and your impenitent heart, you're treasuring up for yourself wrath in the day of wrath and revelation of the righteous judgment of God, who will render to each one according to his deeds. Eternal life to those who by patient continuance in doing good seek for glory, honor, and immortality. But to those who are self-seeking and do not obey the truth, but obey unrighteousness, indignation and wrath, tribulation and anguish on every soul of man who does evil. You're all doing evil. You're all doing you're just selfish. You're just self-absorbed. This is self-worship. This is idolization of self. This is worship of self. This is not worship of God. This is not the worship of the true God, the incorruptible God. That is not made to look like this. This is not the way of God. No. We're trying to turn you from darkness to light. You've got demonic influences in your life that are confusing you, that are turning you from the light of God's word. Yes, but we're trying to love you. We have loving kindness towards you. We're not willing that you should perish. God is not willing that you should perish, but that you should come to the knowledge of the truth. You should seek the truth in love. Seek God in love. Jesus says, if you love me, keep my commandments. If you love me, keep my commandments. His commandments are holy. And you are the temple of God, in which temple you are if you have the Holy Spirit. You need the Holy Spirit. Come out from among them and be separate, says the Lord. Do not touch what is unclean, and I will receive you. I will be a father to you, and you shall be my sons and daughters, says the Lord Almighty. You need to be a son of God. You need to be a daughter of God. You need to come out from among them and be separate. You need to be changed. You need to be born again. You need to be born of the Spirit of God. You were born once of the flesh, but now you need to be born a second time of the Spirit of God. You need to trust in him. He is a sure anchor to your soul. He is a true anchor to your soul. He's immutable. He's unchangeable. He is the demonstration of God's love. He is the image of God. The true image of God is Jesus Christ. He shed his blood for you. He died for you to release you from the bondage of your sin. Jesus says in John 8, most assuredly I say to you, whoever sins is a slave of sin, and the slave does not abide in the house forever, but a son will abide forever. Therefore, whom the Son makes free shall be free indeed. You need to train your child up in the ways of the Bible. You're defiling your child. You're taking your child out here and exposing them to sexual immorality. God is going to judge you for that, parents. He's going to judge you for your sexual immorality. God did not make a child to be sexualized and to be immoralized. He's created them innocent, and you have defiled them by this pride parade, by this event. This is wickedness. Many of you are sexually immoralizing your children into lewdness. This is not the way that God trained up a way for a child to go. God trained a way that the child should be innocent and blameless and upright. You must be like a child to enter into the kingdom of God. You must put your trust and faith in Jesus Christ to deliver you from the power and the bondage of sin. He can deliver you from the power of it. Don't just have a form of godliness, going to church, professing Jesus Christ, but then denying the power to deliver you, the power of the Holy Ghost to deliver you from the sexual immorality of this world. This world is perishing. This world is perishing. It's evil. It's evil, the Bible says. It's corrupted. Do you not know that a man will reap what he sows? Galatians chapter 6 says, if you sow to the flesh, you'll reap corruption. But if you sow to the Spirit, you'll reap eternal life. You need the life that comes from God, the everlasting gospel. Revelation 14, to fear God and give glory to him, for the hour of his judgment has come. The hour of his judgment has come. The kingdom of God has come upon you today. I'm here to tell you the word of God. It is the kingdom of God that has come upon you today. Trust in him, Jesus Christ. He is a sure foundation. He is a sure rock to deliver you from the snares of death, to deliver you from the power of sin. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. You need to return to the Lord with your whole heart. Trust in him, for he is able. He is able to deliver you. He is able to save to the uttermost. Jesus Christ can save you from this depression that you're in, from this anxiety that you're in, from this confusion that you're in. The devil is the author of confusion. He's going to confuse you. He's going to twist you all up. He's going to mix you all up. He's going to say that sweet is bitter and bitter is sweet. He's going to say light is darkness and darkness is light. That woe unto you who call good for evil and evil for good. You are taking the goodness of God and you're turning it into lasciviousness, into lewdness, into idolatry. Look at yourselves. You're worshiping yourselves. This is not the image of the incorruptible God. You need to turn from this vileness. Trust in Jesus Christ. Do you really think this is the goodness of God? Do you really think that God is leading you down this path of unrighteousness, of darkness, of vileness, of uncleanness, of shamefulness? No, this is not the way of God. This is the way of the devil. This is the way of evil. This is the way of lewdness, corrupted flesh. This is what you're doing. You've corrupted yourselves. But God, he can redeem you from every lawless deed. He can turn you from darkness into light. He can turn you from darkness into light. Well, he was light. He's the image of the incorruptible God. Light. You know, Jesus is the Word of God. The Word of God came into the world. It was the light of the world. And then the light shone into the darkness, but the darkness did not understand it. You don't understand the light of God's Word, who is the Jesus Christ is the Word of God. Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Jesus Christ is the light of the world. And in Him is no darkness at all.
Amen.
You need the Word of God to shine into your dark life, to expose all of this vileness, all of this corruption that's in your life. Oh, you're just so full of pride. You're just so full of pride. You're just so full of haughtiness. You're just so full of yourself, selfish ambitions. You are in love with yourself. You are not loving God today. You are not loving Him with the word that He's given to you to walk in the light and not in the darkness. Turn to Him in truth and genuineness and sincerity. He will forgive you. He has shed His blood for you because He loves you. He doesn't want you to die and go to hell, because He's going to judge the world. And righteousness, the Bible says, turn to Him in faith. Turn to Him in faith. You need to have the faith that saves. The faith that saves is the faith that obeys. The faith that saves is the faith that obeys. Oh, but we don't hate you. We don't hate you today. We don't hate you today. We love you with the Word of God. Oh, you're vile. Oh, you're shameful. Oh, you don't love us. You don't accept us. You're not tolerant. You're hypocrites. You guys are just so full of wickedness. You're so full of vileness. So you guys are just throwing stuff at us, hating us. We're trying to give you the Word of God, the truth of the Word of God. It's the love of God that demonstrated His love while you were still yet in your sins. You're in your sins, and you're just so full of wickedness. You don't love me. You don't love me. No, you don't. We love you. We love you. We do love you. We do love you. But that doesn't mean tolerance. It doesn't mean to tolerate your evil. You know, God's love doesn't tolerate wickedness and evil. God's going to take all murderers, and He's going to throw them away into the lake of fire.
There is no lake of fire. It's all fucking
fake. No, it's not. You're going to see it. It's going to be right in front of you. You're going to be going, "Oh, Lord, Lord, help me, Lord." And he's going to say, "Away from me, you practice iniquity." Matthew chapter 7. He's going to push you down the garbage can of the lake of fire. You're going to be twirling around, around, and you're going to be flushed down into eternity. Into eternity. Oh, but God loved you. God loved you. God loved you that He demonstrated His love towards you while you were still yet in your sins. He's saying, turn from your sin. Turn from your sin. Look and live. Jesus Christ said, if I be risen, if I be raised up, I draw all men to myself. But then in Revelation 21, verse 8, He says, all liars, all who love and practice a lie will be cast into a furnace of fire. That's the judgment that comes from God. That's the judgment that comes from God, not me. Not me. Hey, if I'm found to be a sinner, I'm going to be judged by God. If I'm going to be a sinner, I'm going to be judged by God. I have to turn from my sins. And you're violent. You've got an evil, wicked spirit. You've got an evil, wicked spirit. And you know what? You're just gonna burn in the everlasting judgment of God. That's justice. That's righteousness. That's judgment. It's not okay to be gay. It's not okay to be a child rapist. It's not okay to be a murderer. It's not okay to be an idolater. It's not okay to be a covetous man. It is not okay to be a reviler and extortioner. It's not okay to be a thief. It's not okay to be in sin. Sin, sin, sin will put you into hell, hell, hell. But you can be made righteous before God. You know, temptation is not a sin. The Bible says in James chapter 1, verse 12, it says this. It says, blessed is the man who endures temptation, for when he has been approved, he will receive the crown of life to all who love him. Jesus says, if you love me, keep my commandments. If you love Jesus, you will obey him. If you love him, you'll follow him. Jesus says, everyone who comes after me must deny himself, take up his cross daily, and follow after me, Jesus says. Where's the self-denial in this? Where's the self-control in this? Where's the obedience to Jesus Christ in this? He's light. He's light. He's not darkness. He's light. You need the light of God's word to transform you. You need to have the light of God's word transform you. I say be transformed by the word of God. Be transformed by his light. He wants to translate you out of the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of light, so that he can shine light in your life, so that he can shine it in your dark soul and illuminate it. For everything that is illuminated becomes a light. You need to have the light of God. Oh, the light of God is Jesus Christ. Don't you want to be saved from your sin? That's why they called his name Jesus, Matthew 1:21 says. For they would call his name Jesus, for he would save his people from their sins. From their sins. From every lawless deed, the Bible says in Titus. Oh, you can be saved from every lawless deed. You can be saved from disobeying your parents. You can be saved from selfishness, from pride. You can be saved from haughtiness. You can be saved from unrighteousness, from uncleanness, from lewdness. You can be saved to the uttermost. Jesus Christ's blood saves you from your sin. You can be saved today. You need to put your trust and faith in Jesus Christ. He is a sure hope for you in the day of doom. Jesus Christ can save you in the day of doom. In the day of doom, it's going to come upon you one day. There's going to be a day of perdition. There's going to be a day of judgment. A day of judgment.
And let me guess, it's coming soon. Because it's always been coming soon, right?
Well, the Bible does say death and judgment. So whether Jesus Christ cracks open the eastern sky first or you enter into eternity through death, you will be judged by God. And yes, it's coming soon for you. Your life is a vapor. My life is a vapor. We're just all living here for just a moment of time, and then we pass away. Well, the Bible says that it says all flesh is like grass, and all the glory is like the flowers of the field. The grass, it withers, the flowers, they fall, but the word of the Lord will endure forever. This is love, by the way. This is a demonstration of God's love. Don't let your friends deceive you. The Bible says, faithful are the wounds of a friend. Faithful are the wounds of a friend, but the kisses of an enemy are deceitful. You're leading your family, you're leading your friends into defilement of the flesh. Sodomizing yourself is not love. That's not the goodness that comes from God. That's not the light of God's word. Faithful are the wounds of a friend, but the kisses of an enemy are deceitful. The Bible says that that one who spreads a net, or one who flatters with the tongue his neighbor, spreads a net for his feet. You're just all getting your net spread with a big net. You're going to be ensnared by the words of your friends. Your friends are leading you down the path of hell. Man, who needs friends like this? Who needs enemies when you have friends like this? Who needs enemies when you got friends that are leading you down the path of hell? Go right ahead, brother. Go right ahead. Are you ready?
Come on, man. Brother Rick or him? But then
this is God's love being demonstrated. That is not God's love, young lady. Don't listen to your friends. They are leading you down the wrong path. They're leading you down the wrong path. That's not love. Sexualizing your children is not love. It's hatred. That's not love. That's not love. It's dirty, wicked, vile, shameful, unclean. It's not the love of God, young lady.
You want a lap dance?
It's not the love of God. No. No, it's not the love of God. That's pure and holy. God is pure, righteous, and holy.
No,
not according. That's the flesh. That's the flesh. I say then, walk in the spirit, and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. For the flesh lusts against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. These are contrary to one another, so that you do not do the things that you wish. But if you are led by the spirit, you are not under the law. The Holy Spirit's not going to lead you down to defy yourself. No, Jesus said it was one man, one woman, in Matthew 19. One man, one woman, in Matthew 19. What God has joined together, let not man run asunder. Let not man run asunder what God has put together. Let not man separate. You have defiled the flesh. You have taken what was God's and you have defiled it. You've separated what God has joined together. You've separated it. Man and man, woman with woman, committing what is shameful. Committing what is shameful. You're shameful to God. This is not the way that God wants you to live. He wants you to live in the light of His Word. There's goodness, you know. There's normalcy. You know, in God's house, everything's in order. In God's house, everything is put right where it belongs. In God's house, it's pure. God is pure. God does not make mistakes. He put one man and one woman together to populate the earth. What God has put together, let not man separate, the Bible says. Jesus said this in Matthew chapter 19. You're separating what God has made holy. You're defiling what God has put together. You are adding to His Word. The Word of God is pure. The Word of God is pure, the Bible says. Do not add to His Word, lest He rebuke you and you be found a liar. Sir, you're going to be found a liar. We care for you. We don't want you to die in your sin. You could die tonight and then what's going to happen to you? You're going to meet God and then you're going to be crying out. I'm not judging you, sir. I'm not condemning you. I'm not condemning you. I'm not condemning you. No, no, no. I'm warning you. I'm warning you. You're playing with fire. God is an all-consuming fire. God is, you're playing with fire. You're playing with fire. Don't play with fire. The Bible says it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God.
I have a number for a therapist here.
I take my counsel from the Holy Spirit. Yeah, you need the Holy Spirit. That's what I'm talking about. You know, these humanistic views are going to lead you down to hell.
Maybe you're brainwashed. I have a number for a therapist.